Hey everybody, I'm Geno Reynolds from The Real Opinion. Ever since seeing the spectacular Now at Ebertfest last year, I've had the opinion that Shailene Woodley was going to be the next great actress. She was great in the spectacular Now, and she also helped what could have been a throwaway beginning to a new series into something really good with Divergent. Now she gets to tackle another dramedy in The Fault in Our Stars. Did Woodley continue her streak of movies in which she helped make it better? Let's take a look. The story begins with Hazel Lancaster telling us that instead of sugarcoating the story she's about to tell us, she's gonna tell us the truth. She suffers from thyroid cancer that has spread into her lungs, which forces her to carry an oxygen tank at all times. Though she has not given up on life, she has all but given up on things such as having a life and friends. This changes when, at a cancer support group, she meets Augustus. It is in this meeting that she learns that she can have the things that she really wants, even if only for a short while. While I did find this movie to be a bit cheesy at times, from some of the cliches such as stereotypical characters and romantic one-liners, I still found this to be a pretty good romantic film. There were a couple of reasons that I can't write this one off. The first thing is the characters. Shailene Woodley does it again in leading a cast as a highly believable character. She is easy to like, follow, and sympathize with. You laugh when she laughs, are sad when she is, and are happy along with her. I am convinced, for now, that she can do no wrong. Though at first I thought it was a bit weird to have Ansel Elgort play her boyfriend in this, he was her brother in Divergent, I kind of forgot about it pretty quickly. The two just fit pretty well together and had a natural chemistry that made their affection for each other easy to buy. The supporting cast was ranged from either okay to good as well, with Nat Wolff's Isaac being the best supporting character. He's pretty funny. The other thing that makes this one good is the story itself. Though it could be pretty heavy at times, especially when dealing with the subject of death, it also mixed in some pretty decent tender moments along with some pretty good humor. This helped to make the more serious stuff a little easier to swallow. I don't know how faithful this movie is to the books, but I feel that it made a pretty decent love story despite its minor flaws. I did find it to be a bit predictable, but that didn't really ruin anything for me. The movie has a decent story and some likable characters. Fellas, this is one you should take your significant other to. Who knows, you might like it too. And don't worry, I won't tell anyone. But remember, it's only just one guy's opinion. I'm Geno Reynolds from The Real Opinion. Until next time.